First and foremost, I want to give all praises, honor, and glory to Yahweh, Bahashem, Yahweh Shai, Bahashem, Rakah, Kadash, and in the ancient Hebrew tongue, that's the name of the Heavenly Father, Yahweh, and His begotten Son, Yahweh Shai, our Savior. I also want to give double honors to the elders and apostles of GMS for teaching me this truth, having the 100% truth, and the like men teaching the same doctrine on the highways and byways, preaching and prophesying. Shalom to you. Okay, so today's lesson, I want to title it, America's Nakedness or America's Destruction Will Be Seen by the World. If you have, you know, eyes to see, ears to hear, you understand that America's destruction is at hand. We see this throughout the economy. We see this on the political stage. We see this actually in the health field, you know. In the health field, you've got, measles, this outbreak of measles. You've got this thing called the Black Plague that's now affecting not only Americans, but, people all around the planet. In the economic field, America is literally on its deathbed, okay, at this point. And you know, just like a bubble, it's about to burst, you know. In the auto industry, it's over 7 million people who have car notes that are behind 60 days. You know, you've got businesses closing left and right. I believe Nestle is now going to cut 4,000 jobs. So literally you're seeing the display of America crumble. Okay. And why is this being done? It's being done through the Heavenly Father and His Son, Yahweh Yahweh Shai. Okay, so the public display of America's downfall is strategically being done by Yahweh, by Hashem, Yahweh Shai. And it's being done for two main reasons, okay? So one of the main reasons is that it comforts the prophets and the believers, you know, by confirming its destruction, okay? Because for a lot of, you know, two-thirds of our people, and I'm talking about the so-called Blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans, they don't have, you know, the spiritual discernment to understand these things. So as we read and preach, you know, and prophesy, and we read these scriptures and understand these scriptures, it's a very comforting feeling to understand these scriptures and then to see it play out in real life. OK, so that actually draws us closer to our power. OK, when we're seeing these things happen right before our eyes. And then, the second thing it does, it also removes doubt from the naysayers who don't believe. OK, which that's mainly our people. You know, because this word is for them, you know, which, like I said before, which is the Blacks, the so-called Blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans, because you are, you know, the 12 lost tribes of Israel that were scattered throughout the four corners of the earth. So it removes doubt from the naysayers, man, you know, slowly but surely. And most likely, you know, a lot of, like I said, you know, two thirds has to be cut off because it'll be too late till it kind of clicks with you. That's why during this time, you know, as you're seeing things, you should always use discernment. But it, like I said, you know, it does. It's mainly doing two things. You know, it comforts the prophets and the believers, but it also removes doubt from the naysayers. And then, you know, some of our people are just so stiff-necked that they're not going to get it at all. You know, because they don't want to get it. You know, and that's all through the will of Yahweh, by Hashem Yahweh Shai. So let me go to my first precept. This is 2 Esdras 9:1. He answered me then and said, measure thou time diligently in itself. And when thou seest part of the signs past, which I told thee before, then shalt thou understand that is the very same time wherein the highest will begin to visit the world, which he made. Okay. And that time is now. You know, the Most High is now bringing judgment like never before. You know, I'm a 29-year-old man, and, I'm seeing more people my age die than, you know, I've ever seen. You know what I'm saying? Like, this is kind of a new thing, you know, as far as, you know, when you're in your 20s and, you know, you're dying before you're even 30 years old. Well, that's because judgment is upon this planet. The Most High is now revealing himself, and he's starting to visit this planet. OK, this is the last, like I've said in, you know, previous videos, this is the last generation. OK, before Yahweh Shai is coming. OK. And it says, measure thou time diligently. And how do you measure the time diligently? You pay attention to prophecies, okay? You pay attention to prophecies and the things that are coming to pass, you know? So you use, like I said before, you use the world in the sense of a guide. Okay, I kind of it's like using a GPS. So, you know, a GPS, you basically want to go to a destination. Okay, so you program your destination in, but before reaching your destination, you're given, you got to watch signs, you got to watch, you know, how many miles to go, you got to watch if you're turning left, you're turning right, so you got to pay attention to signs and signals, okay, until you reach your destination. And it's the same thing with this word. You know, the destination for us is to ultimately make it into the kingdom and to see Yahweh, why Yahweh Shai, okay, but, you know, but before that, you have to pay attention to the signs and times to kind of, you know, gauge where you're at in this thing. And right now, we're very, very close, okay? Because a lot of the prophecies are coming to pass, okay? You know, like I said before, you know, one of the main prophecies is that the economy is collapsing. You know, you're seeing Payless close, Victoria's Secret close, Sears close, you know, a lot of the malls around America are closing. You know, these are signs that the economy is weakening. And why is it weakening? Because the Lord is he's crumbling Esau, the so-called white man. He's crumbling his system. Okay. Matter of fact, it tells you. Let me go to it. Isaiah 24 and verse 10. The city of confusion is broken down. Every house is shut up that no man may come in. And confusion, and the etymology of that word is Babel, okay, which is Babylon, okay. So that's a key indicator that this is, that's why the scriptures call it Mystery Babylon. This is the city of confusion. This is the nation of confusion, okay. And what's a lot of that confusion? Where homosexuality is okay, you know, abortions are okay, you know, feminism is okay. The women ruling over men, you know, that's okay. And ultimately, you know, the destruction of our people, the so-called blacks, Latinos, and Native Americans. So there's a lot of confusion to where, that's why a lot of people have become disenchanted with this word, because they gave up on their faith, okay, and they didn't seek the heart of Yahweh, why Yahweh Shai, you know, because there's so much confusion around you. But that was done on purpose by Esau to basically make you more carnal, but to remove yourself from your heritage so that you couldn't come back. And if you tried to come back, it would be hard. But that's why you hearken unto the Lord and to for his and call on his right name, which, like I said, is Yahweh Bahashem, which is in the name of Yahweh Shai. OK. So this is definitely, you know, this is definitely the city of confusion, and that city is broken down. Every house is shut up that no man come in. And that's symbolic of the stores closing. OK. Like I said before, you go into a lot of these malls aren't packed anymore, man. You know, a lot of these stores are closed down. A lot of stores actually close early now. A lot of restaurants close early. A lot of restaurants, that's why they kind of offer, you know, free kids meals. And you know, on this day, it's half off burgers. And, you know, this day, it's half off of, you know, whatever. Because they don't, the economy is so bad and people's money is so tight that they, you know, they're still trying to, they still want to uphold this system. You know, if right now everything collapsed and you saw nothing but stores closed down, which is coming, but if you saw nothing but, you know, stores closing everywhere, there'll be a nationwide panic. And Esau doesn't want that. He wants to wait it out because he's so prideful. He wants to wait it out as long as possible. Okay. That's why you have to, you know, measure thy time diligently, man. So you know where you at. And when you kind of, you know, hearken unto to these scriptures and hearken unto the Lord, you become comforted in these things, okay? Because the more you remove yourself from this system, the more Yahweh Bahashem Yahweh Shai, he sits with you, and that comforter sits in, okay, to hearken unto him, you know? But like I said before, America's, you know, the destruction is definitely being seen by the world. And another way that it's going to be seen by the world is this internet, okay? You know, YouTube, everyone has a smartphone. So a lot of, you know, a lot of this is being televised worldwide, you know, which is an embarrassment, you know, for America, ancient Babylon, or excuse me, Mystery Babylon. Just like if you go into New York City, they have I believe it's in Times Square. As a matter of fact, yeah, it is in Times Square. I remember back in 2011 when I first went to Times Square, you look up in one of the, you know, the big, the big towers, and there's a huge debt counter, okay, basically showing how much debt America's in. And that thing goes so damn fast. I mean, every second it just goes up, 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 up. And that's a sign of its nakedness being shown as well, you know? That's like if, you know, for the individual listening, I can log onto a website and I can see everything that, you know, all the bills that you haven't paid and all your debt. You know, that's an embarrassment. So on a nationwide scale, for other nations to know that and to see that, that's an embarrassment. That's the Most High making this place desolate. He's making this place, he's showing their nakedness, okay? They're becoming naked, okay? And also, another thing is, a lot of people, you know, they don't understand. They believe in these kings, and these kings are, you know, your ancient day presidents, your prime ministers. So they think that, you know, if they elect someone, then, you know, they're going to turn it around. Like, you know, a lot of these low-level Edomites, they think that Trump is really going to, you know, he's going to basically, quote unquote, drain the swamp. You know, so all of these crooked officials and congressmen, he's going to drain the swamp and get rid of them. And then he's going to, you know, basically make America great again, which they're not understanding. The Most High is in control of who's a king and who's not, you know. there's no such thing as an elected president. They're all selected, but they're selected through the elites, which are in turn the Most High is putting a spirit on them to basically fulfill prophecy. Okay, and to use them for his will. Okay, so let me go to Daniel 4 and 17. This matter is by the decree of the watchers and the demand by the word of the holy ones, to the intent that the living may know that the Most High ruleth in the kingdom of men and giveth it to whom ever he will, and set it up over it the basest of men. Okay, so the Most High is in control of who becomes, you know, prime minister of a nation, who becomes the president of a nation, who becomes the ruler of that nation. The Most High, Yahweh, he controls that. All right, these people, you know, a lot of people think that that these, you know, like I said, these rulers are elected, you know, which they're not, or they're, you know, doing things of their own will. The Most High is in control of everything, you know. So there's no coming back from this. Make America great again. It's actually God's doing a total opposite. Why? Because the Most High is putting a spirit on him to do that. That's why a lot of the times when I hear Trump talk, it's so funny, because you can see the pride in him. He's literally the epitome of the Edomite, okay, the so-called white man. When he talks, I mean, the guy is so prideful, you could tell he's so detached from reality, you know what I'm saying? But that's the Most High putting that spirit on him to basically be that way. Of course, that's his natural instincts, but like our natural characteristics, but at the same time, the Most High is putting that spirit on him even heavier, okay? This is my last scripture, man. Ecclesiasticus 10 verse 4. The power of the earth is in the hands of the Lord, and in due time he will set over it one that is profitable. Okay, and who is that one that is profitable? That's Yahawashi. Okay, that's going to be the kingdom of heaven, which, like I said before, we're waiting for. So as we look at this kingdom right now that we're in, and we're seeing the desolation and the nakedness of this kingdom come to fruition, we're hearkening unto our Lord even more. You know, we're rejoicing even more, because these prophecies are now coming fast and quickening. Okay, the time is very short, man. You know, we're, like I said, you know, in Second Esdras, I believe it's the 14th and 15th, and maybe the 16th verses, they tell you a lot of about Jacob's trouble and the things that we're going to go into. So even though we're rejoicing for these things, we also understand that this transition period isn't going to be a walk in the park. You know what I'm saying? But at the same time, we have faith in our Lord, Yahweh Bahashem, Yahweh Shai. You understand? So, like I said before, man, you're seeing the nakedness, you're seeing the desolation, you're seeing the destruction of America, And it, like I said, it will be televised. It will be seen throughout the world. And Babylon will be no more. So call Halal Yahweh, Bahashem Yahweh Shai, Bahashem Rakar Kadash. I hope this lesson was edifying. Yasharallah. Keep holding on. We almost out of here.